कोया मम्मे लुगो रामा मे लुगो या मम्मे लुगो रामा मेले नजीदास मेद ना भाग्य मेलु को वैया मम्मे लुगो रामा मेले नजीदास मेद ना भाग्य मेलु को वैया मम्मे लुगो रामा मेले नजीदास मेद ना भाग्य
वेकम ओ रामा देयर इज नो ग्रेटर बून टू मी देन योर अपीयरेंस विद योर कंसोर्ट सीता. Saint composer Sri Tyagaraja longed for the darshan of Rama and Sita. So was Maharajapuram Vishwanathayyar dedicated to Tyaga Brahmam. His dear son, Maharajapuram Santanam too, sang with the same devotion to his father and the saint. Why? He went a step further. In a hurry, he joined them. Joined his father, Maharajapuram Vishwanathayyar, who used to lose himself totally in the soul-stirring verses of this saint musician. Tanjavur, on the banks of River Kaveri, the hometown of all fine arts, like the criss-cross of rivers and canals, bounteously bestowing prosperity to the people, this land remains the springboard for promoting fine arts, the birthplace of top-ranking musicians and composers. No wonder that it is from this land the musical family of conventional Brahmins hailed this great maestro, who was born on the 15th of September in 1896 in a small, beautiful village, Maharajapuram in Tanjavur. Vishwanathan was the son of Amba and Ramayyar, a proficient musician whose shlokas were so enchanting. He grew up imbibing with a natural ease the mastery over ragas like his father, whose vrittams thrilled the doyen of the music world, Poochi Srinivasayyengar. He was placed under Umayalpuram Swaminathayyar for musical training. The teacher became joyous and surprised when the boy demonstrated his musical skill by singing the Saveri Raga so effortlessly. Immediately, he began to teach the first song in Saveri Raga, Muthuswami Dikshitas, Sri Rajagopala, to the boy Vishwanathan. In the later years, the maestro himself had recalled the greatness of his teacher, who he felt could impart Swaragnana even to a stone pillar.
Singaralila Shruta Jana Vajagala Shri.
By the age of 16, Vishwanathan became adept in Carnatic music. Rangappayyar came forward to provide him with knowledge of Laya, and from Muttaya Pillai he learned to master the intricacies of music.
Lila Shruta Jana Vajagala Shri.
His career began with a concert near Kodavasal, near Kumbakonam. In the coronation celebrations of the new king, George V, in Kumbakonam, he made his debut as a performing musician. His deep, vibrant voice became a tremendous success. He began to perform far and wide. He acquired a vast and varied repertoire. He was daringly original in his music, with his voice as his chief asset. In a very short time, he developed his inimitable style, the Maharajapuram style, that took the music lovers by storm. When he was at his zenith of popularity, misfortune struck. His voice refused to match his free imaginative flow of music. Shocked, he began to practice more every morning in the tank at Mahamaham in Kumbakonam with deep reverence to God. Intense exercise, he recovered his melodious voice, much to the joy of the maestro and the good fortune of the listeners. From then on, there was no stopping him. His ascendancy as a top-ranking musician was easily achieved with leading musicians accompanying him.
Maharajapuram avargal romba periya meda. அவர்களுக்கு வந்து கச்சேரியில வந்து பேசும்போது
His voice was rather misleading, making one wonder, is this voice going to give the performance? But once he began to sing, his voice sparkled, taking the audience by pleasant surprise. Maharajapuram Vishwanathayyar had but a few disciples. Each of them remains a class by himself. Dr. Semmangudi R. Srinivasayyar, Maharajapuram Santanam, Mannargudi Sambasivayyar, and his grandson Ramachandran.
Vishwanathirvalukku engittukku asadhya priyam. Shishyannu mathram illene ulle endha mootha poyyanu solluvar. என்னுடைய மூத்த பிள்ளையவான் ஷீனுன்னு சொல்லி வருது கம்ப்ளீட்டா சார்ஜ் எல்லாம் என் கையில தான்
He lovingly treated me like his eldest son. not merely as a student. Santanam too was born later.
Chembankudi Srinivasa Iyer is the most prominent among my father's disciples. It was difficult for pupils to catch his style, as he never sang a raga in the same way twice. I learnt his style by living with him constantly and by singing with him in concerts for many years.
நான் கச்சேரி பண்ணி முடிக்கிற போது முத்தைய பாகவதர் பேசினார். பேசுற போது
Muttaya Bhagavatar paid rich compliments to Vishwanatha Iyer for promoting his disciples in his own lifetime to prominence and preeminence.
அரி என்னன்னு கேட்டாக்க தான் பிரதானமான நிலைமையில இருக்கும் போதே தன்னுடைய சிஷ்யனையும் ஒரு பிரதானமான நிலைமையில கொண்டு வச்சு அவனையும் பெரிசா பண்ணின ஒரு பெரிய பெருமை விஸ்வநாத இயருக்கு தான் சொன்னார்.
Gifted musician of all times. His rendering of Brocheva in the Raga Khamas was excellent. On hearing it, its composer, Mysore Vasudevacharyar, joyously exclaimed, "A pretty girl I sent you. With precious jewels, you have bedecked her."
When he sang Hindustani, it would be very Hindustani accentuation. It is not a Karnatakaized Hindustani, but really Hindustani itself. So he has such a fine ear for Suswara, and his lyre was extraordinarily simple for all singing purposes.
He was particularly fond of Raga Malikas. His Srutva Guna was so packed with Raga Bhava that left the audience wanting to hear more of it.
He has sung to audiences where GNB, the Madhura Maniyar, Chembankudi Srinivasa Iyer were, not to speak of youngsters like me, S. Ramnath and others. He has preached us, he has taught us, has informed us about the classical depths, and at the same time catering to the gallery with the excellence of Tyagaraja Smriti. He said, Tyagarajar's music is so great, it's like Veda Parana. There's a godliness about it. If you have the proper adhikara, proper voice training, proper laya, proper uchiripu, if you have the faith and devotion in Tyagaraja's music, it can inspire any listener, even indifferent listener. He had the conviction and he kept his music very high.
His devotion to Saint Tyagaraja was boundless. He made substantial contribution to the building of a shrine to the saint in Madras. He also popularized some of his compositions, hitherto not very familiar.
Oh,
common traits brought Maharajapuram Vishwanathayya and Nadaswaram maestro T.N. Rajaratnam Pillai together. They hailed from the same district, from just neighboring villages. Both shared a great sense of humor, radiating joy to their friends. Legion were the awards showered on him. 1939, Tanjavur Music Lovers bestowed the title Sangeeta Bhupati. 1945, Sangeeta Kalanidhi. 1955, Sangeet Natak Academy Award. He also served as Asthana Vidwan of Mysore, Travancore, Pudukkottai.
In the year, he presided over the Music Academy's conference. There was a long discussion on how to use the Gandharam and Nishadam in the Ragas Havir. After the speeches were over, he stood up and sang Saveri for about 10 minutes. And this ended the controversies once for all.
Ramani Swami Guru Arupa Kodere Velapati Padua Pramadama.
His Tamil songs were with a passion for the depth of meaning, and naturally, with his captivating voice, he mesmerized everyone, even the accompanists.
My father was reputed for singing certain ragas like Mohanam, Arabi, Devagantari, Darbar and Mukhari, which were his specialities. But he was equally at home in any other raga and was known as the monarch of the Alapana.
His raga sancharas thrilled the audience. Why? Even the people of Sri Lanka, when he was invited to preside over the inauguration of a music college in Marudanarmadam near Jaffna. Santanam, who sang with him, stayed on for a few years on an assignment. People fondly call him Junior Pushpavanam. The dazzle of his voice was enchantingly melodious, added to his endearingly attractive personality.
Sangeet Vidwanulke Shatra Prakaran Sulilka Umba Harkuno Narea Avanam Botukuno Narea Vasane Lam.
It is said that musicians need have a sweet demeanor, and this was his asset. He was immensely jovial too and quick in repartee.
Larutin Salama Peshwa.
A musician called Manakkal Rangarajan once entered his house. Vishwanathayya stopped the musician and asked him to wash his legs and then enter, adding that in Tamil, Manakkal means leg soaked in sand. Everyone laughed. In one of his concerts, a rasika requested him to sing the raga Darbar. He quipped, "You are already in it." The rasika seemed confused. He explained, "Why? Don't you know me? I am the Sangeeta Bhupati. This is my Darbar and you are already in it." An altogether different treat was given in Flute Mahalingam's concert. The maestros were seen in new roles. Leading vocalist Chembai Vaidyanatha Bhagavathar on the violin and the other prominent vocalist Maharajapuram Vishwanathayya on the mridangam. He had a short but impressive stint in the film world. In 1935, he acted in the Tamil film Nandanar. He prostrated before Nandanar, acted by singer K.B. Sundarambar, much to the chagrin of the orthodox of the times.
Maharajapuram Vishwanathayya, who is a great
He was a born genius. His voice was surcharged with brilliance like electric current.
Electric current maari orambal paayu appadikulla or shariram appadikulla or paattu appadikulla or personality.
His recitals were full of melody and stayed in the minds of listeners for a long time. His music is timeless and eternal.
The inspiration was his love and adoration for Tyaga Brahman. In the waning years of his life, this grew into a religious, passionate fervor. He bought and stayed in the family house of Saint Tyagaraja. Every Tyagaraja Aradhana festival, he attended judiciously, leading the chorus singing of Pancharatna Kritis. What distinguished him from contemporary musicians was his free imagination. He would treat the audience to a varied and fascinating string of ragas, and at the end of the concert, lilting phrases would linger on in the minds of rasikas. Despite the passage of years, the masterly handling of his ever-surprising music, flashes, brigas of incredible speed, swarasancharas and niravals was evident. In short, his bani lingers on.
Ni dani 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 dani